Don't waste my time today. City gon' move, yeah, we outside today. I pulled up with a gang, a bunch of young fly niggas.
It was good, Hoodie Gang. I'm back with another video. As y'all can tell from the title of the video, this video is gonna be a little different, you feel me? It's gonna be an emotional topic, but it's something that needs to be talked about because I don't see a lot of people talking about it or none of that. But I know y'all been wondering where I've been. I've been gone, but I'm back into making videos and I'm being consistent. Go follow me and my fiance's. Go subscribe to me and my fiance's channel at The Hoodie Family. I'm going to put the channel in the description. Those for y'all who don't know, yes, I am engaged. I do have a fiance. But, you know, that's besides the point. But as y'all can tell from the title, I'm going to be speaking about the video's going to be about me dealing with depression. This is episode one. Yes, there's going to be multiple episodes because this is something that needs to be talked about, you know. I don't feel like people really talk about depression. Anytime anybody mentions depression, people always say, oh, no, it's not a real thing. It's not a real thing. It's an excuse for people. It's in there, yada, yada, yada. But, you know, for me, I feel like it's cap. It's not. It's bull. But, you know, I definitely miss you guys. I definitely miss uploading. I definitely miss being in front of the camera. It's one of the biggest things, you know. I definitely miss being in front of the camera. And before I get into the video, I'm trying to shoot this video and make it like 15 to 25 minutes the most. I ain't trying to make this a long video because of the fact that it's going to be episodes. So we're going to get right into the topic. Just know if I start crying, I apologize. It's definitely a deep topic for me. You know, it's something I feel like I've been needing to get off my chest because I don't know how to get that off of my chest and whatnot. So just know that if I start crying, I apologize for real. But let's definitely get into this topic. You know, depression is definitely a real thing. There's multiple different ways that anybody can have depression. It can either be from past trauma. It can be from work related. It can be from anything, honestly. It can be from any situation. It can be from family. It can be from anything, you know. It can be with yourself. But, excuse me. I had waffle hours before this. But for me, my depression came from past trauma, stuff I'm going through now. What else? Finance, when it comes to money. Those are my biggest things that make my depression. And my depression started off when I was like 8, started off around when I was 8 years old. Stuff started going on or whatever when I was young. I didn't really have a childhood like that. I grew up way too fast, you know. So I peaked. I had depression at that time, but I didn't really know what depression was, you feel me? I didn't really know exactly what it was, but I've always had that feeling of depression, you feel me? So I didn't really know what depression was. I kept brushing it off. I'm like, oh, it's just a feeling. Left it alone. I can say when I was born, I guess I had this type of thing that I was born with where it's called the Chiari malformation syndrome, right? That meaning that my brain sits on my spine. So it's a condition where my brain sits on my spine. It causes headaches. It causes dizziness sometimes, stuff like that, you know, and it caused me not to be able to play physical sports. And when I say physical sports, I mean like contact sports, like football. I had to stop running track because it would make my headaches go crazy because of the sun. And you know, that played a part because it's like, you know, I love those things. I love sports, period. And I've always been good at sports. So, you know, having that taken away from me was like really bad. But around the age of 8, you know, I became a man at the age of 8. I was doing things that I should have done, you know, the illegal things. I don't want to get too in depth for that because, you know, I don't find it cool and I don't want to encourage the youth to sit there and be like, oh, you know, he did it, why can't I? You know, it's not cool. You know, there's things that I had to do that I shouldn't have to do. But at the end of the day, when, you know, when you're struggling and you have to try to help your family, there's certain outcomes you have to take. And there's certain situations, you know. But time went by after 8. Well, my biggest thing when it came to depression was, you know, I've had events in my life that played a big part. Two situations happened when I was young, really young, same age and everything, happened around the same time. When I was six, I was still in elementary, and I ended up getting molested twice by two different people. I'm not gonna put the names. I'm not gonna disclose who they are. None of that. I'm not gonna disclose the gender. Here comes the emotions. I apologize. I got molested and didn't know how to tell my parents. I really didn't know how to tell my parents because I felt like they wouldn't believe me, you feel me? And with topics like that, you know, it definitely can cause severe depression and it causes PTSD and severe trust issues and stuff like that. But yeah, you know, I went through that and didn't know how to seek help. Didn't know how to tell the ones I love, like, hey, this is what's going on. I was afraid that I wouldn't, you know, be believed or whatnot. So as time went by, you know, I was living with moms, and you know, it was consistent struggles. You know, I can say that my mother has always been there for me, always made sure that we was good, even due to the circumstances or the situations that was going on, whether we had to go from house to house or go from having lights and stuff like that. Like, you know, just regular struggles, you feel me? But it's like, for me, and, you know, not having my dad always around. You know, my dad left at a young age. Like, he was there, but I couldn't say he was always there. You know, I love my pops, and I'm not taking the love away from my pops that I have, because I love my pops. You know, my pops over the years tried his best. Even to this day, you know, he still tries his best. But, you know, I'm grown now, so, you know, I'm on my own. I'm living my own life now, you feel me? I'm 22, I'm living my own life, whatnot. But, you know, the struggles with my mom, you know, definitely took a big toll on my depression, because it's like, you know, we didn't have everything. You know, life was hard. You know, not having a place to stay, stuff like that and whatnot. And, you know, it definitely was hard. The struggle was hard, you know. And then, you know, came around, got to the age of like 15, and my depression started hitting really, really bad. Really bad. I was always fighting. I didn't care for nothing. I was like, all right, you know, I did whatever I wanted. Then I ended up getting a girlfriend in middle school. Before I was like, I don't know, the mother of my child was my girlfriend for like 8 years on and off. And ended up meeting the mother of my child in middle school. And over the years went by, you know, we would always talk or whatever. And then we got serious around the age of when I was like 15. 15 came my biggest depression stage, my biggest suicidal stage, stuff like that. And my reason for that is, you know, I fell in love, but, you know, I made mistakes. You know, I always had the biggest problems when it came to relationships. Even now, like, I can admit, I have made mistakes in this relationship that I'm in. But being with my baby moms, you know, around the age of 15, you know, everything was good. You know, we were still struggling back at home, you know. And then I had found somebody who made things a little better. To then turn around and it was like things became cluttered and things became worse and stuff like that. At the age of 16, things happened and the mother of my child ended up becoming pregnant. I ended up dropping out of school. I dropped out of school for a little bit because I couldn't take my depression. My depression became worse and whatnot. I didn't want to do anything. I didn't care. All I wanted to do was play basketball all day, every day. Didn't care for school, nothing. So being with the mother of my child, you know, I met certain people in my life or whatever. And I ended up cheating a few times and whatnot. And of course I got cheated on too, but you know, my depression made things hard for me because it felt like I needed to seek help in other places instead of going to the person who I was with at the time. The mother of my child being pregnant, I ended up getting into a car accident. I was on a bike and got hit by a car. Really bad. Got a big scar on my back. And my life was almost taken away from me then. And, you know, living with that, knowing that I almost died, you feel me? Living with that, you know, it still plays in my head, getting hit by the car. Sometimes my back and my legs still hurt. My injuries start, like, my wounds and my scars that I have from that accident still, sometimes they hurt. And, you know, living with that, and every time I see the model of the car and the color, it plays over for me. Like, sometimes I'll be in the streets and I see that car and I just be like, oh, damn. You know, but, you know, I still thank God every day that I'm here. I thank God every day that I'm still alive and whatnot. But, you know, there's a lot of things that hold tolls on my depression and whatnot. This is a hard topic for me, y'all. This is definitely a hard topic for me. But yeah, so, you know, living with those things, those traumatic situations that happened in my life, you know, it still goes on to this day. You know, it hurts because a person dealing with depression, it makes you take your anger out on people. It makes you bottle yourself up where you don't want to talk to nobody. You don't want to be bothered. You want to be left alone. You're closed off in a box. You just want to cry, but you can't. You're always emotional. You're always sad. You're always angry. Like, it's a bunch of things that it makes you build up. And, like, yo, depression is literally, like, one of the worst things to deal with. Depression is like crack for crack addicts. You feel me? And it's like, damn, you know, how do you get rid of it? But so the years started getting by. It was a situation where the year that my daughter was being born, I wasn't around due to my mess ups and due to certain situations with the mother of my child. I missed the whole year of my daughter's life. I couldn't see her. I missed the first steps. I missed the first words. Everything that dealt with first, like her first baths, anything. I missed all that. And that year, I was drinking a lot. Like, I was getting drunk every night. Mind you, I was only like 17, turning 18. So I was consistently drinking. I was hanging with the wrong people. I was being stupid. I was being ignorant. Didn't care. I was always out, always fighting and whatnot. And that made my depression 10 times worse. So fast forward to around the age of 19, 20. I ended up moving in with my dad to build that relationship with my father and whatnot. And that's when I can say things got 10 times worse for me. My past felt like it kept haunting me more and more. And that just made me want to kill myself more and more, you feel me? My depression takes a big toll on me being financially stable and me losing motivation to do what I want to do. And I'm not saying this an excuse, but depression is capable of playing a part in that. And yeah, you know, that's one of the biggest reasons I stopped posting on YouTube was because of my depression. You know, my depression has been able to make me lose motivation, confidence, gaining weight, and just not being me and not being happy with myself. You feel me? And it just felt like it kept sinking me and it wouldn't let me progress. So, 20, we was living in this apartment complex. You know, lived there the whole year. It was okay. It wasn't bad. It was okay. And then I ended up turning 21. And we ended up moving into a new complex. You know, and then my stepmom came in with her daughter, whatever. That's when everything clashed. That's when my depression, my anxiety, and my PTSD came in all at once. Everything became 10 times worse. I was cooped up in my room all the time, crying myself to sleep, not being able to sleep. If anybody knows me, knows I can't sleep at night. I suffer from sleep insomnia, or however you say it. But I couldn't sleep at night, whatever. It was making me lose jobs. Like I said, financially messing me up. And then I ended up getting this job at Fun Spot. For those of you who don't know where Fun Spot is located in Orlando, Florida. I ended up getting this job at Fun Spot, and that's how I met my fiance. So me and my fiance have been together now for, it's about to be a year. But in the midst of this relationship, my depression has really messed up this relationship. And when I say it really has messed up this relationship, is because my depression has caused me to build temptation to stupid things. So yes, I can say that I've cheated on my fiance a few times. And when I mean cheat, like, you know, I've texted other females or whatever, never done physically nothing with any other female, but my depression has caused me to, you know, build temptation to certain things. And, you know, and for me as a dude, it's not an excuse. I'm not using depression as an excuse, but depression does play a big role in my life. And You know, those are things I didn't know how to control. Last year, in early August, I was with my fiance. And it was around nighttime. Got into an argument, whatever. And that night, my depression hit hard, like really hard. And I wanted to end everything. I wanted to take the car that I had at the time and just drive it off a bridge. Like, I didn't want nothing to do. I just wanted everything to end. I wanted everything to end. And that night I went home, went to my dad's house, and ended up getting admitted into a psych ward. I got admitted into a psych ward, and I can say that was one of the worst experiences of my life. I didn't expect it to be how it was. I was there for 3 days. They ended up diagnosing me with clinical depression. So I ended up putting me on meds or whatever. So I ended up being on meds for like a month. And then I ended up moving in with my fiance in September. Mid-September. So a little bit after, I ended up proposing to my fiance. I ended up proposing to her in September 11th. A few days after, whatnot. I guess I moved in. And right before my birthday, which is in October. She ended up going through my phone, seeing some things. And I ended up finishing the rest of my pills. My antidepressants. I ended up popping it. Not trying to harm myself, but trying to harm myself. I ended up getting admitted again. I ended up being in there for like a day. And got out. But, you know, for me, depression is, it's taking over. And it's hard to get out of that. It's hard to get out of that. And it's hard to find help when you have depression. Because you feel like everybody's out to get you. You feel like everything is closing. You feel like your heart hurts all the time. You feel like you're not good enough. And with me having the depression, you know, it has made my relationship hard. Because, you know, my fiance tries so much. And, you know, I love her for that. You know, she hasn't given up, but it has hurt her plenty of times. Because, you know, with depression, it's like your emotions change, your feelings change, your moods change. And it's like you have a control over it, but then you don't, because it's like you don't know how to control it. But, you know, this year that just passed and the years before that, you know, my life has been hard. And dealing with depression is one of the most difficult things ever. Dealing with mental health is one of the most hardest things to do, because it's like, damn, you know, what do you do? It's like, what do you do? You don't know what to do. You're so stuck. But I'm definitely going to be making more videos on this. This is definitely just episode one. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I wanted to get more in depth, but like I said, I was trying to shoot 15 to 25 minutes on the video, and I'm already at 24. But damn, this was emotional to even talk about. But now, I hope you guys did enjoy episode one. Please share this, even if you share it on Facebook. Don't matter what you share it on. Spread the word. Spread the message. Spread the love. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I miss you guys. I love you guys. And I hope you guys felt everything I'm saying and felt how I felt when it came to dealing with this, because there's a lot of people in this world that deal with it and don't know how to deal with it and end up committing suicide, you feel me? So all I ask for everybody is to spread the word, share this video, like, comment, subscribe. Let me know how you guys felt about the video, because this definitely was a tough subject to talk about. And I'm not a person who likes to talk about what goes on in my life or let anybody know what's going on, period. But Hoodie Gang, I love you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, because I'm definitely going to be posting more. And please go subscribe to the Hoodie Family on YouTube. I'm going to put the link in the description. Make sure y'all go watch me and my fiance, or my family, my little family's channel. Show love. We have 4 videos up, I believe. 3 or 4 videos out right now. So go show love to those videos. But I'm definitely going to be out. I love you guys. I'm going to be uploading more. Comment down below when you guys want episode 2. I'm going to make this a series. I'm going to make this a 5-episode series. Because only time will tell how bad things get. But I love you guys again. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you share it with a friend. Make sure that friend shares it with another friend. And make sure this video just goes viral. I'm not really looking for views. I'm not looking for clout. I just want the message to be spread. Because like I said, I don't really see nobody making these kind of videos. When people need to hear other people's stories. So like that, everybody can go ahead and come out and help each other. Like I said, my goal is just to inspire somebody else and help that person feel comfortable enough to letting their emotions and stuff out. But this video is over with. Until next time, I love you guys. Okay, let's switch the subject. Notice that both of my wrists is flooded. I've been running so hard getting to this money. I've been working like I know the drought is coming. Money don't-